kicking things off tonight as we get to the final part of our celebration of the creative world of Stan Kenton. You know, we think of the Stan Kenton legacy not only as the music. Well, it's all those pieces together that you've seen this weekend. It's the music, the composers and the arrangers that wrote the music, and all the musicians who played in the band, all the young musicians who attended the camps, and the young musicians who were affected by that many generations down the line. And you see that continue on to today, of the impact that that has had. So the legacy is about the musicians. It's about the alumni. It's about the music. And that's what we've tried to present through the years. And that's what we've tried to present going all the way back to the original event in 1991 with Back to Balboa. So we also like to, not only at the events, not only just play the original Kent music, which of course we've done a lot, but we also like to showcase some of the musicians who came out of the Kenton legacy and what they're doing with their own music. And tonight is a wonderful example of that, of someone coming out of the Stan Kenton Orchestra, became very, very successful, both as a player and as a writer. And his conception of his own large orchestra you see behind me. And so you see, and you see the legacy being continued, and you see it with the Kim Richmond Concert Jazz Orchestra. Kim Richmond.
Thank you very much, Ken. I'm going to preface this first selection, because you've heard it almost every day, well, every day, Artistry and Rhythm. And this might be the last time you hear it today, but can't say for tomorrow. But this is an example of using all the identifiable parts of Artistry and Rhythm, and yet having them sound different and in a different order. So this is my version of Artistry and Rhythm in 5/4.
Thank you.
Well, it's a little different. Anyway. Yeah. When I was in the band in the 70s, that's, excuse me, 67, 1967, when I was in the band, you know, Stan let his views be known, let's put it that way. And he had a lot of decisive, well, prejudices maybe, okay, and about instruments and about people. And he changed those later on the 70s, but he didn't like to have woodwinds. He didn't like woodwinds and all. He thought they were sissy instruments. They don't play loud enough. I had my soprano along on the tour, and I played intermission riff on a tenor solo on soprano. And he, after about three dates, he said, "You might as well leave the soprano in the car, or in the bus." Okay, so I did. So he didn't like the soprano that well, and he didn't have women in the band at that time. You believe that? And that all changed too. So he had some very good players that were of the feminine gender. So that was really great. So we have, what we're doing here is we're kind of guessing where Stan might have gone from there. And so that's one of the things, that's the way I put that together. This number next is called Adjustments. And the title comes from my wife, because she says every once in a while, we have to make some adjustments here.
Thank you. Thank you.
John Dixon on the French horn. John Dixon. On the trumpet, Chris Berg, back there on the trumpet. Brett McDonald on the tenor saxophone. And the clarinet. Anyway, that's adjustments. So let's see, who did I miss? Any? Oh, the bassoon solo was by Brandon Wilkins over here. And we have a flute melody by Alex Budman on that first tune. Did I miss anybody? Huh? Matt? Yeah, sure, whatever. Matt Franke on the lead trumpet. Yeah, it's a melody in there, thank you. Brian always keeps me straight, so that's okay. Okay. As straight as I can, anyway. Huh? Okay, a good friend of mine, his name is Clay Jenkins, and he's gonna be our guest right now and play one of my favorite Bill Matthew arrangements on The Meaning of the Blues. Clay, come on. Thank you. Clay Jenkins. Clay Jenkins. Yeah. Okay, we're going to do another number. We've got a couple more for you, but the only thing is that they take about 20 minutes each. Is that okay? I'm kidding. So this is called Twixt Light and Darkness.
Thank you.
Thank you. Brian Schwartz on the trumpet. Alex Budman on the clarinet. Yeah. There's somebody who's not afraid, I'll tell you that. Okay. You know, we might think of this kind of approach to things as a neophonic attitude. You know, Stan had a neophonic orchestra for a few years. How many years? 3 years or something like that? About 3 years, yeah, in L.A. here. And I got to sub in the rehearsal one time, but other than that, I was on the outside. But anyway, I was much a fan of it, and I have the recordings and so forth that they did. And it was an orchestra with strings and a whole shebang, you know. But I'm as close to that as I can get in instrumentation. We can't afford the 50 strings. So, but this next and last tune is going to be something that you may like or may not like, but it's the direction I'm going, and whether that's good or bad. It's a little outrageous, and I did it in a period of my life where I was going through some outrageous stuff, so, you know, that's, I won't go into that, however. But this is called, aptly, it's called Crazy Ladies. I'm still married.
Thank you. Thank you.
Reverend Donald on the clarinet. Trish Eames on the piano over there. I didn't mention Chad Willis on the solo before that. Yeah. Who else will play a solo? Huh? Okay. We've got one part number for you. We're going to do it. I usually just don't even announce it. And here we go. Just to hold on. Thank you. Thank you so much. You're a wonderful audience. Thank you very much. Thank you. No encores. I haven't got any notes left. I don't know that it was where Stan would have been going, but it's where I went. Thank you.